video is about forts of entry through drop bars. We're going to talk about using irons to get through drop bars. We're also going to talk about using the K-12. The majority of this video was filmed at Marachek Middle School, which was an acquired structure that we had. So the techniques you see here are really a culmination of what we found to be most effective at getting through drop bars at that particular structure. So please enjoy. Drop bars are secondary locking mechanisms that span across the door and brace up against the wall. These are typically found on outward swinging doors at commercial structures, usually on the Charlie side of the building. However, they can be present on inward swinging doors and at residential occupancies. Most often these drop bar setups are homemade, but can be commercially fabricated as well. Identifying drop bars on outward swinging doors is relatively simple. Most commonly, you're going to find carriage bolts in 2 to 4 bolt patterns that are in line with each other. Okay, so what we have here is a metal door. This is going to be, we're indicating this is an outward swinging door. This may be something that you typically find on the Charlie side of a strip mall. So you'll notice a few things here. You'll notice these carriage bolts. They indicate the presence of a possible drop bar. So what we talked about in the beginning of the video is always starting forcible entry with conventional means on the lock side of the door. There's two reasons for that. The first is the drop bar might not be in place. So if you waste a lot of time trying to force these drop bars only to find that they're not there, that's a big fail. The second reason is if I can get enough capture, if I can get enough gap in this door, I may be able to clear the drop bar with a tool, so just sticking a New York hook in and just popping the drop bar off. So those are the main reasons we start with conventional forcible entry first. Okay, so let's take a look at the actual carriage bolts themselves. So you see two different setups here. The first setup doesn't have any washers. So oftentimes these carriage bolts will have washers or plates. And that protects this drop bar from being pushed in or forced by something like a halligan from the outside. Okay, so with this type of setup, without washers or plates, we can force this with halligans. We'll teach you how to do that. Okay, so we're talking about how we're actually going to start forcing these now. We're going to start with this side. So what you notice with this side is you do not have any type of metal securing plate or any type of washer. So with this type of setup, I can force these with my halligan. The goal here is to be able to take the pike end of my halligan and make a cavity around these carriage bolts to push it through that metal. So if you picture this lip of this carriage bolt right up against that metal, if I take the pike end of that halligan, drive it through above, drive it through below, I can weaken that metal to be able to push this bolt through. So that's your goal. So what that requires is that requires you to be able to move your tool to different locations to try to puncture through that metal. One thing you may find when you're doing this is that pike end of the halligan is going to butt up against this bracket. So you're going to hear a change in sound with your tool. It'll go from hammering through this nice soft metal in the door, butting directly up against this bracket. So you'll hear a high-pitched ping. When you get to that ping, oftentimes you're gonna make very little progress trying to continue hammering it at this point. If you hit that ping, you can readjust your tool, start working on making that cavity larger to clear that lip so you can force it through. The other thing to keep in mind is while I'm creating a hole by puncturing through different locations around these carriage bolts, I can also use different parts of my tool. So if I have a large enough gap through here, I can use my adz to cut through this last section of metal to hopefully be able to push those carriage bolts through.
The main door versus the second door, he went the opposite. Yeah, that was you. Yeah.
We're not talking about K-12 views. What you notice here, again, we have the two different types of carriage bolt setups. So if this type is bolt setup, when you have the washers or the plates, you have to cut this with the K-12. So the method we use for that is to take this at a shallow angle, and we're actually gonna grind the head of the bolt off. After you've ground the head off of this bolt, you need to take the pike end of your Halligan to drive the shaft of the bolt through the bore. So you're gonna have to strike that through the bore. That'll clear it. You can also cut this type of bolt with the K-12 as well. And this is an effective way to get through these this style. The angle, the approach angle will be different. We're gonna start at a 45 degree angle. Again, high RPM, we're gonna be cutting through the door. It's called a plunge cut through the door. And we're gonna cut the bolt through around the middle of the door. So this is an effective way to get through this style, and it's likely faster than even using ironwork.
With inward swinging doors, you're not going to see the same bolt patterns you would see on an outward swinging door. The reason for this is the bracket is mounted on the inside of the wall. Our method for forcible entry with inward swinging doors is going to be based on our conventional techniques. So refer back to our first video, we talked about gas pedal technique and gapping the door to identify the locking mechanisms in the door. Once you have an idea where these are, you can focus your efforts on forcing it at those spots. Once you have a large enough gap, you can attempt to stick your tool in and clear the drop bar from the bracket. There are alternative methods for gaining entry if you fail to force the primary and secondary locking mechanisms, such as drop bars. This cut is called the Dutch cut and is designed to bypass the locking mechanisms and drop bars. This technique should only be considered as one of the last options if the other techniques discussed failed. This technique takes much longer than it looks, and the final cut from the door to the frame is very demanding on the saw.